Alléluia. 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 Good morning. Happy new day. Happy new month. This season, God will bless us. God will protect for us. In this new month, we move from glory to glory, honor to honor, and from grace to grace in Jesus' name. Amen. This is Love Word, taking you open heaven, a guide to a close fellowship with God. The topic before this morning is fake friends. Fake friends. Our memory verse can be found in the book of Psalm 55, verse 21. I read, "The word of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was his heart. His word were softer than oil, yet were they drawn sword." The word of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in heart. His word were softer than oil, yet were they drawn sword. When you read the story in Mark 5:35-42, you will see what happened in the house of Jairus. In the word from long ago, it tells you that fake sympathizers have been in the world. When Jesus came and said everyone should go out because the child was not dead, but only sleeping, the Bible reported that they laughed him to scorn. They switched from weeping to laughing within a second. That means they were not sad to start with it at all. I am happy that Jesus chased them out of the house in the name that is above every other name. Jesus will chase fake friends out of your life in Jesus' name. When the widow of Nain in Luke 7:11-17 was going to bury her only son and Jesus met her on the way, there were a lot of people there who pretend to be sympathizing with her. But I'm sure that they must be saying, "Is she the only one in the town? Why is it that strategy upon strategy is befalling her? First, the husband died. Now, the holy boy she had is dead. God must be punishing her for her sins." That is why they must have been saying until Jesus got there and stopped the procession. One of my children once say, "The grave digger were waiting. They already dug the grave. The mourner were waiting to do the final mourning at the graveyard. But the Almighty God disappointed them. Every grave digger waiting for you this year will be disappointed in Jesus' name. Everyone waiting to mourn over you will be disappointed in Jesus' name. Anyone who thought he or she has succeeded in making you sad, by the time God turned the tide, you will laugh last. Everyone at one time or other will encounter fake friends. That is why you must be careful who you call your friends. Not everyone who call themselves your friend should be close to you. Not everyone who come close to you should know your secret. Not everyone should be given access to your inner circle. The Bible says that you should love even your enemy. Matthew 5:44, but does not say everyone should be your friend. So, love them from distance. Be good to people, but don't make them your friends if they have not really proven to you beyond any reasonable doubt that they are true friends. You don't need many friends. Proverbs 18:24 says there is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. It didn't say there are many friends. It says a friend. Brethren, our key point for today: beware of fake friends. Beware of fake friends. I want us to read the book of Proverbs 26, verse 23 to 27, and our Bible in 1 year, Jeremiah 34, verse 36. Let's pray. Father, we bless you. We glorify your name all the time because you are the God of living. Bless us this week. Bless us this month. Bless our way. Guide us. Protect us from the hand of enemy that call themselves our friends. Give us the opportunity to witness more grace and life in Jesus' name. Amen. Brethren, this is Love World. Till I come your way tomorrow, remember, subscribe, share, and like. And God bless you as you are doing so. Till tomorrow, have a nice day. Bye for now.
We are redeemed, united in love. Jesus is for us. We shall conquer. Hallelujah. 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 We are together.
Somebody shout hallelujah.